The most effective form of gun control never bans a single gun. It just controls the way you think or the way your neighbors think until enough people voluntarily give up gun ownership so that tyranny can win. So let's learn this sinister strategy of the left and how we can fight it. Hi, I'm Rachel Malone. I'm Texas Director of Gun Owners of America. And today I'd like to talk about mind control being used as a weapon for gun control. Let me back up. There's a certain strategy that I've used many times, and I'm sure you have too, whether or not you even realize it. When I was a music teacher, I required my students to practice a set amount and to get certain things done when they practiced. But I noticed that when I gave them an incentive to want to do the things that they had to do, I got much better results. So I focused on showing them the joy of creating something beautiful. And sure enough, a lot of them started practicing extra, not because I was forcing them to, but because they wanted to create that something beautiful. Many of you have probably experienced homeschooling some kids during the coronavirus shutdowns. I did too. One of the kids was struggling to write out a single line without mistakes, so I promised him 2 chocolate chips for every line that I didn't have to correct. And you know what? It's amazing what a difference that made. It seems that overnight, he gained the ability to write multiple lines in a row perfectly. Frankly, it's nothing more than the Tom Sawyer strategy of making whitewashing a fence look like the greatest thing in the world. Of course, he used it so he could manipulate his friends and get out of work. But there are many ways that we can use this strategy for good. For example, teaching our kids good, healthy habits. And there are also ways that it can be used against us for harm, such as to enact gun control. The strategy I'm talking about is mind control. And in the fight for gun rights, we need to be very aware of how the gun grabbers will use this strategy of mind control to manipulate the way people think about guns. It makes people want gun control instead of realizing it's dangerous. History shows us that this kind of mind control has been used to enact some of the worst gun control with the least resistance. For example, look at Nazi Germany and the disarming of the Jews. Now, most of you who are listening, and probably most GOA Texas members, I'm not worried about anti-gunners changing your minds. I'm not worried about you waking up one day and wanting to take away all of our guns. But I am worried about this mind control getting to your neighbors, your friends, your family, anyone who is not so secure in understanding that guns are a necessary tool to help us stay safe and to protect our liberties. And when enough of them are affected by this mind control, your gun rights are absolutely affected. So, let's talk about how they use mind control, and then I'll give you an example used right here in Texas in our last legislative session. And then I'll give you a few suggestions for how you can fight against this mind control. When I was a music teacher, I made my students enjoy practicing instead of forcing them to do what they hated. When I promised chocolate chips, I made them want to write perfectly so they got a reward. And when Tom Sawyer hoodwinked his friends, he got them to believe that whitewashing a fence is something that everybody wants to do. Now, that's exactly what the anti-gunners do. They rename, incentivize, shame, apply peer pressure, and use false logic so that people are duped into thinking they want gun control. Have you ever heard the terms gun violence or assault weapon? These terms were coined by anti-gunners to make guns sound awful. In reality, have you ever heard of a violent gun? I haven't. But they want people to think guns are responsible for evil, while in fact, guns are used many times more often to save innocent life than to take innocent life. Now, what about gun safety? That's a tricky one because we use it too, but when I say gun safety, I mean treat every gun as if it's loaded. Always point it in a safe direction. Keep your finger off the trigger until your sights are on the target, and be aware of your target and what is behind it. But when they say gun safety, they mean keep your guns locked up where nobody, not even yourself, can get to them easily. Now that's dumb, because we know we might need to access our guns to save our lives. Responsible gun ownership is similar. There are a lot of anti-gun organizations claiming to be advocating for gun safety or responsible gun ownership, when in fact, They're all funded by Bloomberg and promoting the idea that responsible gun ownership means setting up gun-free zones and all sorts of regulation, or even banning whatever sorts of weapons or ammo they think are too dangerous. The anti-gunners also give incentives for gun control. For example, some local governments hold gun buybacks where they offer cash for guns. Usually it's just $50 or so, and typically people bring a lot of broken guns or gun parts, but still, they use the trick of an incentive. And they shame gun owners. One of the most common tactics is to stigmatize gun ownership and people who own guns. This happens on social media, in schools, in employee handbooks, store policies, and in government. The more extreme examples include the kids who were bullied or even disciplined at school for wearing a pro-gun shirt, drawing a picture of a gun, or talking about going to the range with their family. My friend Layla Pierney experienced this at Harvard when her housemates searched her room because they thought she might have guns, and they actually called the cops when they found guns. She wasn't breaking any law, but they shamed her, and the landlord kicked her out. Of course, it's our gain because she came to Texas, but it's horrifying to see how people will treat gun owners. Other examples of shaming include no gun signs on stores, or people reporting Facebook posts that talk about guns, or private social media companies censoring those posts. Usually, that's not a government action, so we don't fix it with legislation. Instead, it's a society problem of people stigmatizing gun owners, and it leads to more gun control legislation. Peer pressure is related to incentivizing and shaming, and the anti-gunners use it when they try to normalize gun control. They try to show gun control measures as being normal and gun owners as being weird and radical. Don't you want to be a team player? Don't you want to be normal? Don't you want to be one of us? For many people, that's a compelling argument. They'll think, hey, if everyone's doing it, I probably should be doing it too. And if the anti-gunners can convince them that everyone else is going for gun control, they will too. Now that's extremely dangerous. And then there's the false logic. This also goes hand in hand with the others. We've probably all heard of the 30 magazine clips you can shoot in half a second and other stupid things that politicians say. Now, there's also the basic illogic of gun control, where they try to say that banning guns will stop crime or keep the criminals from getting weapons. Those are pretty easy to see through when you're honest with yourself. But there's another illogical concept that's a bit harder to spot. Earlier, I mentioned how anti-gunners use the term gun safety to mean keep your gun locked up. Now, when they use that line of thinking, they are subtly saying that guns have no valuable purpose. They present guns as if they're always dangerous. Of course, if a gun was always dangerous and never had any good purpose, we might all get on board with encouraging people not to carry them around. But nothing could be further from the truth. So, while we fight the renaming, we also need to fight the illogic presented with the terms like gun safety as they mean it. So, those are five basic ways that the anti-gunners use mind control to try to get to people to want gun control legislation, so they can pass their gun control without as much of a fight. Now, Texas politicians and anti-gun activists have been using mind control strategies for a long time already. It's nothing new. But I'd like to give you one example of how they used it in the Texas legislative session in 2019. During the 2019 Texas legislative session, an anti-gun representative filed HB 316. This bill purported to establish a statewide public awareness campaign for safe gun storage and suicide prevention. It used $1 million of taxpayer money for this public awareness campaign, and it was very open-ended. It tasked multiple government agencies with developing the program. Now, let me ask you a question. Do you care about gun safety? I hope you said yes. I care about gun safety, and I hope you do too. But when we think of promoting gun safety, we think of teaching people how to use guns safely. During the hearing for this bill, it was very clear that is not what the bill author had in mind at all. Multiple people testified in favor of the bill, saying that we need this program to encourage gun owners to always keep their guns locked up and never accessible to them. They gave examples of people who committed suicide or who were even killed by a burglar who got to the homeowner's gun first. And they said that if these people had kept their guns locked up, maybe they'd still be alive. Of course, it's horrible and it's tragic when people die needlessly. That's why encouraging people to always keep their guns always locked up is a terrible idea, and it will result in more people being needlessly killed because they're not ready to defend themselves. Gun storage does not have a one-size-fits-all solution. Proper gun storage depends on the circumstances, and it can't be legislated properly. The bill was absolutely about mind control. It was all about infecting people with the idea that guns are dangerous and all of them should always be locked up. I'm glad that HB 316 was killed, and I'm proud of GOA's part in stopping it. What I learned from this is that the war of public opinion is being waged right here in Texas. People's minds haven't been infected enough yet to let HB 316 pass as a standalone bill, but they have been infected enough to let a similar concept get through when it was buried inside the Texas budget. Who knows what kind of bills will pass if they keep up the battle for mind control and we don't fight back? Oh, I know, all the worst gun control. That's why we have to fight back. We kill their bad, false ideas with the truth. We win by waging our own battle for public perception. If you've been listening, you already know the most important thing in this battle, and that is to reject the mind control. Now, the big lies are obvious. We also have to recognize and reject the subtle things, like when they talk about gun safety, but they really mean nobody should have easy access to a gun. But recognizing and refusing to believe their attempts at mind control, that's not enough. We've got to be proactive also. The anti-gunners are attempting to demonize guns and gun owners. As a response, we need to be gun ambassadors. Now, this concept really is a whole topic in and of itself, and I'd love to hear all of your ideas about how we can be great gun ambassadors. But here are a few of my specific ideas of how we can all be ambassadors for our ideas and for our way of life as gun owners. First, use truth when you talk. For example, don't cave to the terms that they try to give us. Magazines that hold 30 rounds are standard capacity. They're not high capacity magazines. Carrying a gun is what a safe, responsible person does. It's not something weird. If someone is frightened, don't gloss over their fear, but share with them reasons they don't have to be afraid anymore. And maybe that's as simple as just explaining how a gun works or how other people have used a gun to save their lives. Second, normalize guns. One way I do this is to sometimes choose to open carry. I like it when people first notice that I'm just a normal person like them, and then they notice I also happen to be carrying a gun. Also, we as gun owners can sometimes do a better job of communicating that gun ownership isn't for an exclusive subset of the population that looks a certain way or talks a certain way. For example, it's not just for rednecks, it's not just for country people, it's also for people with pretty nails and girly dresses, it's for the geek, the businessman, the soccer mom, the college student, it's for everyone, because all people deserve the right to protect their own lives. Third, an armed society is a polite society. So all the time, but especially when I'm open carrying or wearing a gun shirt or a GOA hat, I'm conscious that I am looked on as a representative of gun owners. If I'm rude, people may get the impression that gun owners in general are always rude. If I'm kind and helpful though, I give the impression that gun owners are kind and helpful people. I'd much rather the latter. So think of yourself as a gun ambassador. Behave in a way that helps people see gun owners in a positive light. Those are a few of my ideas for proactive ways to wage our own battle for public perception. All right, let's recap what we've talked about today. The gun grabbers love to use mind control to turn the general population against guns and against gun ownership. They do this through renaming, incentivizing, shaming, applying peer pressure, and using false logic. They're already hard at work on the war for mind control right here in Texas, and we can't let them win. To fight the battle for public perception, we need to recognize and reject their attempts, and we need to be ambassadors for gun ownership. Be a good example of someone who owns guns, use truth when you talk, and help to normalize guns, so that people aren't afraid of guns, but they recognize that guns are a tool that can help them stay safe. Thank y'all so much for listening. And as always, if you find my work helpful, please be sure to join Gun Owners of America to make sure we can keep fighting for your gun rights. Go to gunowners.org/Texas to join. And if you'd like to connect with other GOA Texas members on Facebook, look up our GOA Texas Facebook group. Thank you for caring about our important liberties, and thank you for helping to preserve liberty for our posterity.